I'm so glad to see you. I know it's been quite a while again, but during this last month, or maybe even two, I'm struggling with some various minor health issues, so I dedicated most of my time to getting rid of the stress and sleep deprivation that caused all this. I also had to undergo a minor surgery on my right upper eyelid. There's a small scar here, but I guess in several weeks it's going to be completely invisible, and in all other aspects I already feel much better now, so I hope to be back on track, especially after a vacation I'm going to have in a week. It's the first time I'm going to have a holiday away at the seaside, and this is going to be my first time in 6 years, so I'm really looking forward to it, and let it bring me real peace and rest, which is, I hope, is also something you can get from this video. I do not have any specific plan. I'm going just to touch your ears maybe and tap or scratch at two or three objects I have. I'm also not using earphones with this video, just as a kind of experiment. My theory is that I'm going to feel a bit more free without them, but let's see. Maybe it's not worth it, but it's always worth to give it a try, right? My mic here has those fluffy windshields again, though you cannot see it at the moment since it is attached to the tripod. But they are here, and I hope you can feel it when I touch your fluffy ears gently with my fingers. Without earphones, it feels for me like going a bit blind in my actions and movements. But at the same time, this way it could become a more of a intuitive approach. senses at the end of the day. Relaxation is our main goal. You know, I got really inspired by guided meditations during the last 2 weeks or so, and of course I've tried it before, but this time I've installed an app which is quite popular, and you can choose any option you like from literally 1 minute relaxation session based on breathing and noting the sense of your body and mind, to like half an hour wind up, wind out, I don't know, unwind, I must say, probably, yeah. So, sorry, I'm trying to make it as flowy and spontaneously as I can, since this is what I need right now, and probably some of you do as well. And I thought I'm going to do only the things I really feel like. To me, this is the only way to make something genuine. This is kind of my credo in this period of time. So, first of all, I have a yellow silicone star, which is actually for washing the dishes, but I've never used it. Since I didn't want to spoil the sound effects it produces, I've already used it in some of my layered videos. And I guess I'll make some more when I have time. And I guess I will have time, since my priorities seem to be shifting. For instance, my priority now is sleep, the first and foremost one, really is sleep to me. I've been trying to sleep for more than 8 or 9 hours a day during the last almost 3 weeks, and I haven't had this experience since I was maybe 15, and I feel so differently right now after these 3 weeks. So I feel really enthusiastic about sleeping right now. Sleeping is your best friend, especially if it's done in the right time. I believe that your bedtime shouldn't be too late, even if you're used to it, but I can only be sure for things related directly to myself. And when I slept for enough time during the first 3 or 5 days, I was thinking that that's overrated, that doesn't work, since nothing seemed to be improving at this point, and I felt the effect only after 2 weeks or more. I started feeling really refreshed, first during only a couple of hours a day, and then during a half a day. Actually, this is the point I am at right now, and I hope someday I will feel good during 8 hours. And this actually incurred kind of the second wave of appreciation for ASMR community for me. I've been using those brilliant videos for sleep and relaxation for maybe 5 years now, but right now I just can't express how grateful I am to all the ASMRists out there who make it possible for, I don't know, maybe it's safe to say millions of people to relax. This is so important. So important that sometimes I cannot believe it. These thoughts also reassure me, since I started to believe that even my own videos with some random rambling and ambient noises still can make at least someone feel more relaxed, maybe spaced out, maybe bored, since boredom is actually really, really useful for our mind. So now I'm doing it a bit more, you know, deliberately, knowingly. So please try to relax even more, and feel the weight of your body. And the way of your breath. Filling you from the inside and then subsiding gently. And maybe try to concentrate on being rather than doing or thinking. I believe that many pleasant things in life are often underappreciated or underrated since they are so simple to practice. We tend to looking for something profound and sophisticated and complex. Maybe this is a modern feature. And maybe it's in human nature. From the beginning of time, I don't know. But what I know for sure is that it doesn't hurt to let go of all the worries and remember that you have this opportunity almost 24/7. I also have a blue plastic glass, if you can call it a glass, if it's made of plastic, I don't know, but it looks like this. Looks very cheap, but the sounds are really rich. On the contrary, so if you can right now, just try to forget about your chores and duties, fears. Because it's only going to be like 5 minutes. try to concentrate on these faucets. Reflecting the light and making it sparkly and light blue, and producing this comforting rattling sound. Do I look all that gloomy again at the camera, I wonder? You can see by my face that I'm stressed out and have anxiety issues, since I always have that frowned look, especially when I think that my face is relaxed and neutral. It's just like grumpy cat, almost. I've always wanted to have a relaxed face, just naturally relaxed, and maybe with a kind of a friendly look, or at least tranquil. But I don't know if that's even achievable to me. So sorry for the grumpy face. Now let's get back to these beauty from a thrift shop. Oh, it's actually from a supermarket, but the section was thrift. Not have any ideas for a Halloween video as for now, and I don't think I'm gonna have time for making one. I had one the last year when I've almost just started my channel, and I thought it was quite brilliant, but now I know it was a crap. Well, basically, and I do not know what can be soothing and relaxing and at the same time connected to the Halloween thing. I can tell you a scary story in Russian, and it will only sound scary since it's going to be in Russian. That's lame. So I guess I'm gonna get some props can touch them. And light the candle from the last year. Skull-shaped one. My battery is going to die soon, so let's move on. And let me touch a pillow next to your ears. This is one thing that always made me sleepy. I'm also going to go to bed soon, which is wonderful. And I love going to bed. A couple of days ago, I read a survey and it mentioned the reason why we find so appealing to stay up late at night. And that's the thing about releasing dopamine, which fires when we stay up late, and it reduces the melatonin, which is usually supposed to get us sleepy, and if we don't go to bed after 10 p.m., after 11 p.m., after the midnight, then it stops releasing in most cases, and that gets substituted by its antagonist, dopamine, which makes you feel agitated and enthusiastic and excited, which is why it's so pleasant to eat candies and pizza and anything, almost anything tastes better when you eat it staying up late, right? And then the books you read are more interesting when you're doing it late, as well as TV shows and movies. That's an addiction. And to me, after understanding that, it was much simpler to go to bed on time. And I cannot stress enough how important this is. The consequences are very, very long term. That's why I can see people who go 10, 15 years with the sleep deprivation and they seem totally okay and they think, oh, you do not need that much sleep, look, they're doing okay, but wait till they are 45 or 50 years old and then we'll talk. Let's go to sleep then. I love you guys. And I wish you all good night. Sweet dreams, good health, nice friends, and anything you'd personally like.